Welcome back. In this video, we're going to look at setting up standard sales codes so that you can have reoccurring sales orders or sales invoices have the lines template kind of pull in rather than having to create it from scratch. It's worth noting that when you set up standard sales codes, that's on the customer sales, sales order, sales invoice side of things. But you can also, once you've learned the sales codes, leverage it on the purchasing side as well. So you're able to set up standard vendor codes so that when you have reoccurring purchase orders or purchase invoices, you don't need to set up the same line information over and over. You can just use that as a template and then move forward. So this video will outline the standard sales codes on the sales side, but again, you can leverage this on the purchasing side as well using standard vendor codes. Let's jump into Nav and see how that looks. So the first thing that we want to do is we want to go to our search bar and type in standard. So I'll use sales codes in this example. So what we want to do is we want to give it a code. So you could do anything that you want. You could do 01, you could do A, you could do ACC if that was specific to a specific customer if you wanted. And then what you can do is you can select the edit. So the edit screen allows you to put in that template information for your lines. So you could say a standard, maybe this is a standard accounting template. So you guys will define what your codes are, what the descriptions are, and then in the line information, again, that's where you're going to want to put your defaults. So the same as we have on a sales order, as you've been learning, is you can have different types of sales order lines. So we could expense directly to a general ledger account. We can have a sales line where it's an inventory item that we're going to sell. It could be a resource for labor time or time for a person doing some service work. It could be a fixed asset, or it could be a charge item for something like freight that you wanted to actually take a charge and put it into an item. So in this example, I'm just going to select item. The number field will drop down. So if I have type as item, when I drop down my number list, it would be a list of my items. If I had selected, say, for example, a general ledger account, when I drop down my number column, you can see that that's a list of my general ledger accounts. If I had selected resource and I drop down the list, it's a list of the resources that are set up. So you'll select the type that you want on your sales document, and then in the number column, depending on the type, you'll select the corresponding item that is associated to it. So I'm just going to select any item just for the sake of it. And say each month, 36 of these are purchased from us. So we need to have that on our sales line. Maybe there's also some, let's see. Let's pick one of these models, two of those. And then maybe we want a general ledger line. And then we want to overwrite that with some So here all I've done really is set up a template for my line information so that when I go to a sales order, I have the ability then to be able to pull this standard sales code for a certain customer, and then I don't have to re-key in this detailed information every single time. Then what I can do is I can go to my customer card, because you need to associate standard sales codes to customers so that you can select them on sales documents. So if that accounting template was associated and I could use it for multiple customers, I need to associate it to those individual customers. I only do that once, but then it's available to me so that I can use it on sales orders going forward. So I'll select customers. And then what we can do is we can do two things. So on our customer card here, under Navigate, we can select standard customer sales codes, which would bring us into the field and the page where we can associate this. Or you could double click to open any one of your customers. And under the Navigate, you would see something called recurring sales lines. So in previous versions, this was called standard sales codes, like it is on the sales list page, but on the actual customer card, it's called recurring sales lines. And then from the drop down here on code, you would have a list of all the standard sales codes that had been created. So again, that's why I had mentioned in the code column, you may want to have a reference to the customer number if it's a specific recurring sales line for that customer, or, you know, the code is really something that you can just make something that stands out to you. So here I've selected that there. If I wanted, I could look at the card. So this shows me that default information that we set up, so I can validate that that's the right standard code that I want to use. You have your validate from and validate to. So say, for example, that sales code was something that was promotional or something that was only valid for a certain period of time. You can indicate that. You can also indicate payment method, payment terms code, the debit or direct debit mandate ID, all those things. If you select the recurring sales line for this, when you create the sales document, it would also default this payment information as well. So once you've gotten that selected, you can then have that standard sales code for that specific customer on a sales document. So again, I've just associated this for Atlas Precision. If, say, Condoxy and Fairway Sound both had the ability to use that template, I would need to go into their customer cards and associate that standard sales code as well. So just a key piece of information there. So now if I navigate to a sales order, and I create a new sales order, I will select my Atlas Precision. You'll notice I obviously don't have any line information that's come in. So say, for example, I now wanted to apply that standard sales code because I didn't want to have to key in that information all the time. I can go to Actions and say Get Standard Customer Sales Code. So when I do that, I can see that accounting standard that I had associated, if I had multiple sales codes, because there may be scenarios where you might say, well, I could have 5 or 6 different templates for a certain customer. You would list and see all of them there. Once I say okay, you can see that those 3 lines defaulted in based on the customer sales code template that I had created. So 36 came in for quantity 2 and 1. Of course, at this point, I have the ability, say, for example, they said, you know what, this month I'm going to order a little bit more. You could update that to 5. Of course, here, because this was a sales charge, maybe that's different on the order, and you'll notice that unit price wasn't included as part of it, so I have to manually enter that in. But now what I've done is I've leveraged existing sales lines with reoccurring items or general ledger accounts or resources with maybe reoccurring quantities. Again, I chose to include that in the standard sales code. I may not have if maybe the line detail is the same all but the quantity. So basically what I've done is, again, I've taken the ability to take some reoccurring function that I do, create a template for it, and then just pull that into my sales documents and leverage it as I need it. And then from there, the process would be the exact same for managing the sales orders as you would see if you had created it just by entering in the lines individually. As always, if you guys have any questions, shoot us an email or give us a call, info@sabrelimited.com.